Okay, let's see if this works better. There's the giant fire tornado over the lava. My boop stick. Fire things, it's better to have the rice poop stick. Oh, Fire Dasher. We are not friends. Fire Dasher has a couple of interesting things that he does that normal Dashers don't do. Like, you know, red tornado and red chocobo impressions like that. And then the fiery, you know, body slams. Which I'll admit, I could totally live without the fire body slams. If you see me running through lava, that's okay for my character, where the pirate lady seems to be on fire. I have a set on that actually, it has kind of skills all over the place, but one of the skills that it does have is I am immune to lava, so I cannot be set on fire. I can still take damage from fire, but I'm not gonna get set on fire if I run through lava or anything like that. Let's see if we get anything interesting here. Pack tactics, go time. Ooh, Thrill of the Hunt. Thrill of the Hunt's fun because every behemoth that we kill will add 10% damage to me. It's when you get later into one of these escalation runs, not so useful, but if you pick it up right at the start, it's actually lots of fun. And we have the lava quill shot. Normal quill shot's a pain in the rear. This one, you can see firing the quills all over the place, and then they set themselves on fire. And then they explode. And you might be asking me, Hedrick, why in the world, if you dislike that fire one so much, aren't you going to kill him? Well, it's more because he's even more of a pain in the rear when he has company. And with my boop stick, as you've seen, there's times where the enemy will actually fly towards us, and I can knock him out of the air like that if I time my attack with my boop sticker. Which is one of the reasons why it's called a boop stick. Oh, I'm forgetting to do that. I gotta charge up my thing. So if you look, I have that little kind of percent damage meter on there. And that actually increases like all damage that I do. But Once it's all, once it's charged, I can do this and store it. Which allows me to do other things. The normal version that you get to do with it is, it'll actually shoot like a kind of a cannon blast in a way at the enemy. I can still smack the enemy for a little while afterwards. After they're dead. Which allows me to do some charge. The big glowing ones like that are max charge ones. They do the most damage. Otherwise, it's all respectable damage, but I like waiting until I have all. I'm gonna go with Breath of Life 2. Let's see what we have next. Oh, Negaza. Belly, and we'll interrupt him there. It right with one of your attacks, you can actually hit back the electric balls. That goes for enemies of me are doing electric ball attacks too. The thing about mine, because I'm swinging it in a huge arc, it tends to knock the balls back in weird directions. And come over here so you can see it when it breaks. Now I'm going to do my jump. But it works, and I'm happy about that. Let's see, do they give me anything good? No. In case I have to res another player, now everybody gets a shield when I do so. Oh yeah, we have Pangar there and Shroud. Lovely. You will notice in these escalations that they like to toss Shroud into it a lot. I'm generally okay with it if I'm weird. I like fighting Shroud when it's just Shroud. And I'm ready for him, I have my stuff. And he's not a super pain in the rear. The problem that comes in is when you're in one of these and you're geared up, ready to fight one of the bosses. And then it's like, oh, we'll just toss a Shroud in here just for the lulls. See that we have a whole bunch of shield money. Hear me call them poop sticks. Now, generally, you can boop Shroud with this. It's just really getting the timing for doing the booping is kind of difficult. Of course he is. Oh, he's right there. Has a weak spot in, it'll always regenerate the weak spot in a different spot when you broke the first one. I can do this, and that'll tell me exactly where he is. I like to call it the Dinky King. Ugh. you can see, some of his attacks aren't terribly difficult. Aren't terribly difficult to read, but if you're in the middle of something, it can be very difficult to dodge. Here we got him with his clone. Now all it takes to clear, when it says that you have corruption, all it takes to clear that corruption is one hit. Just hitting him once with your weapon will get rid of him. But it also slows you. So if you're across the room, getting that one hit can be difficult at times. Let's heal up because we're going to the show. Now whenever you do this, each one of these escalations will have a couple of steps. Let's see, torn shield. I think I'm gonna take this one. And what you're looking for is, we got that thing up in the top right that says 49. As long as that is above 40, you get to fight the big boss monster of the area. If it's not above 40, the game pretty much says you're not good enough to take with this team for you to take on the last boss. And it won't even give you an option. It'll actually just kind of boot you out and say, nope. And a lava monkey. Oh, hi. Yes, I see you there. Okay, so he's gonna run over there. If we can survive that. So there's a little mechanic where you can get through that tornado without anybody being hit. Oh shit. Help, I need a dope. Oh, I needed the butt slam. Yeah, if he can do the tornado and not hit anybody, you can dodge out of the way. He will actually fall over and give you free hits. Pick somebody up. Grab me in the meantime. already on top of him. Getting mushed is not an idea.
Oh, that doesn't go very well.
I'm not trying to get up.
No.
I just want a couple of lava bananas. Is that too much to ask? If you gave me some lava bananas, I wouldn't be in this position. I wouldn't even need to fight you. Yes! I got my lava bananas. As they get more damage taken to them, they'll start having a couple more problems. They'll start stumbling a little bit more. They'll just generally have some issues that they might not normally have. Yeah. took a little bit more than I thought it was going to take. But, you know, sometimes you get to... You gotta play the team that you get, not the team that you want. So... Yeah, I didn't do too great on Mr. Lava Banana, but I got three of them. And that means I can do something now. So I've been saving up. I already have the sword already fully powered up over here. So now I'm getting the spear. So, got the first stage of the spear. As you can see, I need quite a few more lava bananas in order to finish this up. So, that's something that I will do a bit later. Have fun!